Hello, and welcome to Skills to Pay the Bills. I'm Tia Young, your host. Our special guests are back today by popular demand from our YouTube viewers who wanted to know more about this dynamic family of David and Donna Burkes, co-founders of Safe Money Retirement Solutions, and their daughter, Christina. So I will not keep you waiting 1 second longer. Let's find out how this family business is surviving and if they still love each other after working together as a family for almost 1 year. Donna, hi, how are you doing?
Hi, I'm doing great, Tia.
How are you? Good, and there's my buddy David, how are you?
Fantastic.
And cool Christina, how are you?
Awesome.
That's great. Well, let's get started because I've got tons of questions here for you. Donna, can you share with the viewers what is Safe Money Retirement Solutions?
Safe Money Retirement Solutions is a company that offers various products to customers. So we have unique products in the sense of we can help protect retirement accounts. It's exactly what it says. It's a whole range of financial services where the client will never lose a penny in the market. And so everything that we offer, we can guarantee them that one, we will try to find the best solution on the market and or in the industry, I should say.
Right.
And second, that they will never lose anything with us.
Wow, that's fantastic. That's almost too good to be true. We're going to talk a little bit more
<It is>.
About the actual types of products that you offer. But let's do some straight talking now. It's almost been a year since you guys were last here and you had started working as a family. You were all very excited and, you know, ready to go, raring to go. What I want to know from each of you, do you still love each other? Have you just had a fit? And is there anybody that's ready to say, I quit? So let's start with Christina down there. How are you feeling about this venture?
No, I still love them. I'm not ready to kill anyone.
Good.
But it's going great so far. It's going really good.
And I know, Christina, you're working a lot with the 18-year-olds to 35-year-old group. And has that been easy, or is it a little difficult now, or how's that been?
It's about the same. I still talk to people, but I've been more focused on the health side and becoming the health expert in the company.
Right.
But other than that, I still hit some life here and there.
Good. Okay, Mr. David, what about you? Have you had to put the commander here in her place?
Sometimes we have to put her in check, but she's okay. But no, it's been a good year. We've learned a lot and struggled through some things, but basically it's been a good learning experience and we're still married. It's been a real good year, and we've learned a lot together and as a family and as a business.
Good. That's good. Okay, Commander Donna Burkes, what do you have to say?
Yes, of course, I still love these guys. So, yeah, it is. So after a year, you find that you do have some professional differences. So you do come across that at some times, and there's still training going on, and, you know, there's various aspects. But all in all, it's back to what we said, you know, last time. It's all about communication and just keep it moving.
Right, and so you guys are moving towards year two. You're going to
keep
this thing going. Yeah. So what Refocus. Do you find, like, you have certain strengths, and Dave has certain strengths, and Christina has certain strengths, and you just kind of, you know, each one of you builds on that? Is that how you set things up?
We do find that. So each of us, like healthcare, an example. So I try to minimize what I do with healthcare. So if we come across a client that is in need of healthcare, then we will throw it over to Christina and let her handle that and get the quotes and et cetera for a client. So,
right.
Yeah. And so, and then David just kind of, you know, and then we're looking at, we're still kind of strategizing and refocusing, how do we want to go forward with year two so that each of us kind of become more experts, have more expertise in certain areas.
Right, I understand.
Yeah, diversify.
Right. Well, why is this business so important to you?
This business is important to me because it really affects individuals and families at the core level. I mean, personally and financially. So we have had a couple situations, and I'll share one story with you. briefly was we had a client last year. It was a friend. It was a brother of a friend of mine. And we had met him at a barbecue. He had wanted some insurance, and we were trying to do that for him. He's a truck driver. He was on the road all the time. We kept trying to meet up with him, and we were not able to do it. So we finally mailed the application to him and said, hey, please sign this so we can get this in for you. And we kept calling him, didn't get a response back. Well, finally I contacted my girlfriend, or no, she sent me a text and said that her brother had died. And he was 65 years old, had a heart attack when he was on the road.
Oh my.
And so, I mean, that really hit because that was close to home for me. And then months later, my girlfriend asked if people could contribute to help her pay her mortgage, because she had to use the money to help pay for his burial, and because he had no insurance. And I felt so bad. I was like, what could we have done differently to, you know, not have that occurred? And you know, but it's one of those things where, you know, it really does make a difference in somebody's life. And so she had to play catch up on her mortgage so she didn't go into a foreclosure and et cetera. So yeah, we really do make a difference in people. That's just one example of many stories.
Right. Mm-hmm. Well, using that example, David, has that made you feel stronger about leaning in on people a little bit more? Because I know sometimes you'll talk to somebody and, you know, they kind of don't want to do it. It's like maybe they're just pushing you away, and you say, oh, okay, just forget them. Let me move on to the next person. But hearing a story like that, you know, I'm wondering, does that make you feel like you just need to lean in on people a little bit more? Because yeah, they don't understand what they don't know.
Mm-hmm. Right, yeah, you do have to give them an example and tell them how very important it is, because we're on this earth just a short amount of time. So we need to protect our family if something happens. And as Donna was saying, you know, our family has to pick the bill up if, you know, there's no insurance there for them. Right. So it's very important to try to explain to them, you know, what the importance is of this and how important it is.
Right, right. And Christina, you were dealing with the younger group who, I remember when I was 18, I just thought I was going to live forever, that I was invincible. And I don't know, I don't recall anyone ever trying to even talk to me about protecting myself. But, you know, you're bold and you're out there doing that. You know, how would you parlay that to a young person who feels they're invincible? You know, to let them know that a day is not promised to you.
Well, I have a situation where one of my friends, he had open heart surgery. Mm. And he's around my age.
And that is, do you mind telling?
I'm 26.
Okay.
I don't mind.
All right, good.
I don't mind at all. It's cool. I'm 26.
She's still at that age. Oh, she doesn't mind.
Oh, to be 26. Oh, to be 26 again.
Wait till it doubles.
I still tell it doubles.
So he's had open heart surgery at, mm-hmm. at 26 years old.
Yep. Okay. And he lives with a friend, and so he has no job right now. And he is struggling to pay what our life insurance, what our policy could have offered was to cover that expense. What he had to go through in the hospital, pay for all that could have helped him. And I didn't know that he had health problems. And I never, actually at one point, he actually did want to talk about it with me. And I never got back to him, and that happened.
Wow. So it is important not to try and prejudge the people that you see, because you just never know.
Yeah,
really,
exactly.
Never know. Wow, that's really that's really thought provoking. It really is. Well, I want to go back to some straight talk again. How do you guys wind down from a day of working? Now, I'm not sure if you operate out of your house or if you have a business outside of the home. How do you turn it off? I mean, so when you go home, so you have a because you know you're working together, and you know, and the pressures are there. And Donna, you know, sometimes you may have to crack the whip on David or on Christina, and then you got to all come home. How do you balance that?
It's you do and you don't turn it off. We schedule things, you know, so we still do other events, but it's not just a business, it's kind of a passion for us as well, as being able to help people. And so we also, so it's part of our life too. Mm-hmm. So if we're out and we end up talking to somebody, we could go into business talk, you know. It's just integrated as a part of us. But at the same time, there's times you come home and you're done. You know, like Christina still has her schedule and she still, you know, does whatever she's going to do. And like, sorry, Mom, no. But, you know.
Okay.
Yeah, but sometimes, you know, we have a meeting, you know, we can have ad hoc meetings. Say, hey, guys, let's talk about this. Let's strategize or let's, you know, think about this. Or, hey, I need to follow up. What's going on with that client? You know, so.
And did you ever have old Dave over here tell you, Donna, turn off the phone. we're going camping.
Really, because every call is very important, because you don't know if it's that person that really needs your help. They're calling for a reason. Mm-hmm. So really, the phone, it stays on, you know. But we do have our time together, and we do plan trips, and you know, we have timeshare, so we use it. And we're planning a couple trips real soon, so we do get away together.
Yeah, and we were just in Oregon like a week or so ago, and visiting family, and so we didn't have cell phone, you know, a lot of the time. So, but at the same time, that's an example of talking to my dad, because he's having some medical conditions. You know, we end up talking about the business because he's looking for final expense.
Right.
So yeah,
because your business is really a people business. So. You know, I guess you can be on a vacation and end up talking to somebody, and that conversation goes into a business,
business
type of conversation.
Exactly.
And it also brings me back to Christina again, because I know that you're still living at home, which is nothing wrong with that. I think that's really cool. You can do that. You're able to do that, and you guys get along. But are there examples or times when you do have to say, I heard you earlier say you have to say, okay, Mom. This is it. Do you find yourself in moments like that?
Yeah, sometimes I have to, I like a stopping point at a certain time. I'm like, okay, I'm done. I want to, you know, veg out or just relax and have some downtime. And other times I don't. I'll come to her at random time and ask a question, because the question will pop up, well, what about this, what about that? And so, but I have that freedom to have that privacy, though, or to go to them, one of them, and ask them a bunch of questions.
Right. So you feel like, as a team, I want to see if everybody's on the same page. You feel like you have been able to balance the business and the professional. I mean, the business and the personal. Right. Business and the personal. You've been able to do that.
Yeah. I think so. But the unique thing about this is because we are a family. You know, we do things. So if we're on a trip, you could end up talking business going down the highway.
Right.
You know, so it makes it kind of nice. Or the fact that we share the same passion. So it's not just work. So, you know, it's not the same as if David had a job and he came home and he's telling me about his, you know, automotive career, and I'm going, that's great, honey, you know, but I'm bored. I don't really want to hear it all, you know, but we do it together, so we can relate to each other and understand. Yeah.
Right, that's good. Well, folks, we are going to take a short station break. We'll be right back with special guests Donna and David Burkes, and their daughter, Christina Johnson. Don't touch that dial.
Filing for Social Security online. 9 out of 10 experts agree it's groovier than a Brooklyn hot dog. Or Crips is it.
When cousins are two of a kind.
Welcome back. You're watching Skills to Pay the Bills with our special guests, Donna and David Burkes, and their daughter, Christina Johnson. Prior to the break, we were discussing several things, but during the break, David started telling me an example of something that happened when they were visiting South Carolina, and I want him to share that with you. So David, would you share the South Carolina story?
Sure. We were in South Carolina just checking out the area, because we're getting ready to retire some couple years or so. And we were at a restaurant, and it was really nice food, and then the manager came over, and he asked us how the food was, and so we just got into a discussion, because he's a local, and we asked him all kinds of questions about the area. So we went on for about 5 minutes or so, and we got on the subject of what type of work you do. So that really opened it up to, you know, hey, we're into the health insurance and the life insurance industry. And then he said, hey, my daughter needs health insurance.
So he actually approached you about
it.
You didn't even
have to. So at any time is a good time.
Right. So, Well, you know, I think what we're going to do now is we're going to shift gears a little bit. I've been poking into your private and personal lives enough through part one. So let's now get into a little bit more about exactly what it is that you do. I want to know about your signature products and why these products are so unique.
Okay. We have a couple that are really our flagship products. And I would say they're basically for everyone, you know, just about. So I can give you an example. So I'm kind of tell a story with it because it kind of helps explain it. So our son-in-law, he has one of the products. So it's an insurance product, but at the same time, it's also has a, it's called a life savings account. And the reason is that it can protect you all the way through life. So for example, he has $100,000. If something happened to him, he could actually access his death benefit while he's alive. Now, and he can take money from that to help him through his hard time, because you know healthcare does not pay for everything. And so he's going to have a deficit of, you know, 20-30% that he's going to have to pay. So he, and so example, if he couldn't dress himself, feed himself, it's kind of like a long-term care policy in a sense, he could access that. And it's not his cash value, his savings account, it's his death benefit he could access.
See, I was going to ask you that. I said, so does that mean that his cash value is decreasing?
Mm-mm.
But you're saying that the cash value is still building.
Mm-hmm.
And
still there.
This is coming from the death benefit.
This is the death benefit. They call it the policy you don't have to die to use. And then what happens is if he doesn't need that and he, you know, clicks on, he can become his own banker and get a tax-free retirement income when he's 60, 65. So, or he could take money out, so a child could take money out to help pay for college, to put a down payment on a house, to buy a car, to do whatever. And so it's very awesome. And
wow.
So not only does he have that, so one, he's preparing for retirement, two, he's protecting himself medically if something happens, three, he's providing protection for his family in case something would happen to him and they lose that wage earner. And then, so our grandchild, who is now about 3 weeks old.
Congratulations. Yes.
Thank you. We're going up to New York next week, actually, to see them. We're going to open a policy for her. And now she will have a big retirement account by the time she gets to that age.
She has a time for it to grow.
Exactly.
Right.
And then we hadn't done one yet on our daughter, so we need to do her too, because her husband wanted to do one first. So basically, for about $200 a month, the whole family would be covered. And
for $200 a month?
Yep.
So the entire family would be covered?
The entire family would have individual policies. And
they're individual?
I was thinking
it was one policy.
Individual
policies.
Now, that's just one. The second one is for retirement. So mm-hmm. folks are planning towards retirement. And some, you hear so many different things in the news about where's the economy going.
Right.
Some says it's going up, it's going to crash again. It happens in threes. We haven't had the third fall yet. Mm-hmm. So there's a lot of different people that have views. Well, with ours, let's say you have an old 401k, you have money sitting in CDs, et cetera, somewhere, and you want to do something with it, you could move it over and you could get a bonus right immediately. It could be anywhere from 5 to 10% bonus. And then you can earn anywhere from 4 to 20%, depending on what strategy, what product you select.
Mm-hmm.
And the beauty of it is, you never lose a penny. So if the market goes up, you can earn that amount. If the market drops, you don't lose a penny.
So what happens? It just goes...
It freezes. And
wow.
So you will never lose any money. Mm-hmm. And on top of it, you get lifetime income out of that. So if you had $100,000 10 years, you take $10,000 out, your account balance goes to zero. Mm-hmm. Guess what? You still get paid. You would still get $10,000 for the rest of your life.
That's amazing.
It's awesome.
I had a question. I was thinking about the child. Are these policies transferable? Let's say that child is now 30 years old and getting ready to get married.
Mm-hmm.
Can that policy be turned over to that child, or are you, continue to own it?
The child, it belongs to the child.
So yes,
that child can have that policy, and she can continue to put money into it. And speaking of, if you know how you hear about kids, unfortunately, that have diseases and cancer and things, well, if something happened to that child, she's 7, 10, 15, doesn't matter, 25,
mm-hmm.
we have a guaranteed insurability. So if she got married or she had a child, she bought a house, she can actually increase her insurance with no medical exam.
Oh, wow. Donna, how can people get in touch with you guys?
they could do that by calling. By calling 571-643-1842. Or they can contact us at safemoneydcmetro@gmail.com.
Wow, that's something. So now, so that's one signature product, flagship product.
That's
life
insurance.
Is that life insurance?
That's
okay,
correct.
So do you have something else for us?
Yes, the one, the second one that I was talking about was the one that a lot of people use for retirement. It's called the annuity. It's an indexed annuity, but it is not the product of old. It is not the type of product where if you started taking money out and you died, the company kept your money. Mm-hmm. In this case, if something happened to you and you were not able, and you still had money left in your account, it's passed to your beneficiaries, or they have the option to take that account over or transfer it into their own name so they can have lifetime income as well.
Wow.
Yeah, and it's you can't beat that product. There's some other features to it now. They have like a long-term rider, a long-term care rider on it that's free.
Right.
Yeah, and based on your age and et cetera. So very, very cool features in that product. So we also have disability. We have we can set up 401ks for businesses that really would like to have one for their employees. We can, you name it, we basically can do it. Except we don't do car and auto, but we can. we don't do homeowners. Yeah, we don't do property, but we can. We can do term.
I hear there are a lot of new products out, but they have new term products out now.
You can actually get return on premium. So you know, only about 2% of term is paid out. So usually you're gambling you're going to die, and the insurance company's gambling you won't. Yeah, and so what happens is you get to that term and your money's gone. You have nothing to show for it, right? You get to 30 years, say that's a 30-year term. You hit there, you have nothing. Well, they have a return on premium. You hit 30 years, then you can get your premiums back. Mm-hmm. So
the term, is that what we mostly see with employers where they're offering the term?
You do.
And so that's why when people are fired or quit or retire, they don't have any coverage.
Exactly.
But they're older, so they have to pay more.
Exactly.
Am I right?
You are right.
See, I'm learning this stuff.
You're a smart cookie.
I was on another show, we'll tell you more.
Okay. And we will definitely do that. Now, I heard Christina earlier say that she was becoming the expert on healthcare, and that is a big subject. You know, we know that a lot of changes are coming down the pike. So can you just share a little bit with us just about, you know, what you do with the health insurance?
With the health, I basically look at their situation and see what product best fits them, because I don't want to give them something that their company can give them and it's not going to do them anything,
right.
You know? And you want to look at, the most important thing is to look at the client's needs.
Right.
And so, and there's a lot of different health coverage out there, different companies, and with the 2014 rolling around and how that's going to affect everyone's concerned about that. Companies are concerned, individuals, families, they're concerned on how that's going to affect them health-wise and their insurance and their coverage. And so I am like out there trying to learn more and more as like, I'm still learning, because I don't know everything about health, so
right.
I'm still
right.
learning it.
Right. Okay.
And so, but from what I've seen, it's the health coverage is only going to go down.
Some of the plans are changing.
Everything's changing.
As far as what's going to be offered in the plan, it's going to be less. And so what we're looking to do is put together some little seminars that we could go out and start educating employers free of charge,
right.
You know, to go in and say, hey, let us explain to what that means to you. And as far as to individuals, too. Yeah.
And I'm thinking just, you know, in my own head that it is kind of scary out there with a lot of people losing their jobs, and maybe some employers are just having to shut down their businesses. So you got all these people out here who are not covered, mm-hmm. You know, and some folks, I don't think they even realize that they can own their own policies.
Mm-hmm.
Do you have anything to add to that about people owning their own policies?
I think it's smart. Yeah, it's definitely smart, because when you own it, it's transportable. So if you leave that employer, then you can take it with you. So example, of course, you know, when you come to healthcare, and employers cover a share of that. And so a lot of individuals, you know, they don't want to put out the expense of having their own policy versus the employer picking up the share. But it's happening to a friend of mine. She's leaving a job next week, and of course she'll have no health care over the weekend, so she's praying nothing happens to her till she gets to a new job and gets the policy into effect.
Right.
And so, and she has a son, you know, he's like 9 or 10.
Oh, no.
Yeah, so he can't leave the house next weekend. He has to stay right there in the house. But actually, for life insurance, it's very wise to have your own policy. because again, it's term. So I would recommend everyone to have a permanent life policy.
Mm-hmm. Well, we are just about out of time. We got just a couple of minutes left, but I wanted to, if you guys could quickly tell me what your roles are in the company. I forgot to ask that earlier, and I was just thinking, okay, you found out, what is old Dave over there doing? Is he just cracking the whip on everybody, or is he answering some phones?
He answers phones. He does windows, too.
Yeah. I answer a lot of phones. And talk to a lot of business owners, and we just joined our county chamber of commerce.
So good.
We're going to a lot of them meetings and introducing ourselves, our business, to the community because we live in our Prince William County, so we want to sort of try to do business in Prince William County. Yeah. Okay. But we do business all over the states too. But we're trying to get the chamber of commerce to get to the business owners. To let them know exactly what we do.
What you do, okay. Yes. All right, very good. Well, our time is just about up, and I want to thank Donna, David, and Christina for allowing us to peek a bit into their private lives and also to learn more about the exciting world of their financial services business and how they are able to make a difference in the lives of the people that they touch. If you need to contact this powerful family, their contact information should be scrolling on the lower part of your television screen right now. If you need to chat with me about this show, Skills to Pay the Bills, please contact me at skills2rock@gmail.com. Have a great weekend. And bye-bye.